Good morning, students of class 9. In today's lecture of maths, we are going to learn the representation of decimals on the number line. In the previous concepts, we have seen that all the rational numbers can be converted into decimals, right? And we have seen the decimal expansion of every rational number. Okay, so today's concept, we are going to learn representing decimals on the number line. Okay, you know the number line. We have in earlier classes we have seen that all the numbers like natural numbers, or whole numbers, or integers can be represented on the number line. Similarly, these decimal numbers also can be visualized or represented on the number line. How to do that? Let us see here. We have here three examples of decimal numbers. Two are terminating decimals, and here 4.27 bar, that means it is not terminating, recurring. Okay, so now we will see the representation of these decimals, representation of both these cases on the number line. See here how to do that. First examples we have 4.862. Okay, 4.862. See the first step. What we have to do? Draw this number line. Now see this number 4.862. If you think about this number, 4.862 is greater than 4. Means 4.62 is greater than 4 and less than 5, right? That means what you know? 4.862 comes between 4 and 5. Understood this? 4.864 means this number is greater than 4 but less than 5. That means it comes between 4 and 5. That's why what we have to do, this number line we have here, right here 4 and here 5. Okay? And the line segment between 4 and 5, let us divide it into 10 equal parts. How many equal parts? 10 equal parts. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 equal parts. Assume that these are 10 equal parts. Means the line segment between 4 and 5 we have divided into 10 equal parts. Okay. Now see. Here, after 4, which number will we get? 4.1. Means we are writing decimal numbers between 4 and 5. So after 4, this 4 means 4.0, right? It is actually 4.0. Then here 4.1, then 4.2, 4.3, 4.4. Then we have 4.5. 4.6, 4.7, then 4.8, and here 4.9. Understood this? First thing understood. What we have done? We have number 4.862, and we know that this number comes between 4 and 5. That's why on this number line we have located first 4 and here 5. And the line segment between 4 and 5 we have divided into 10 equal parts, and each part we have each part is located by the decimal number. Okay, so here 4, then 4.1, 4.2, 10 here, 4.9, and then 4.10 is 5. Okay, now on this number line, now see this number 4.862. Okay, now this 4.862. Here we have 4.8. Can you observe 4.8? And this number 4.862, after 862 means comes between which two parts or which two numbers here? 4.8 and 4.9. That number, our number will be somewhere here between 4.8 and 4.9. Okay? Getting what I'm telling? Our number 4.862 which is between 4.8 and 4.9. Somewhere between 4.8 and 4.9. That's why we will magnify, we will zoom the part between 4.9 and 4.8. 4.8 and 4.9. That part will zoom. Means in this way. Again, we draw a number line. Means this part we have zoom actually. Okay, means here. Here we have 4.8 and here will be our 4.9. Okay, means this part we have enlarged. 4.8, 4.9. Now again this the line segment between 4.8 and 4.9 will be divided into 10 equal parts. So 1, 2, 3, then 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and this one 10. Means 4.8, 4.9. The line segment between 4.8 and 4.9 we have divided into 10 equal parts. So now see, after 4.8 we will get 4.8 means 4.80. 4.80, then 4.81, 4.82, 4.83, 4.84, 4.85, 4.86, 4.87, 4.88 and 4.89. And here after 4.89, 4.90. Understood? That is 4.9. Okay. Now between in these numbers, again our 4.862 will come between which two numbers? Here there is 4.86. So where is 4.86? This. Correct? So 4.862 will come between 4.886 and 4.87. Here somewhere. 4.862 will come between 4.86 and 4.87. That's why what we need to again need to do? We need to enlarge this. We need to magnify this. Okay? So again, let us draw the number line to magnify this, the part between 4.86 and 4.87. So let us do. Okay, here 4.86 and here 4.87. And again the line segment between 4.86 and 4.87 we need to divide into 10 equal parts. Okay, so let us do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Okay, so this the line segment between 4.86 and 4.87 we have divided into 10 equal parts. Okay, now let's give a number to each point. Here 4.860. 86 means 4.860. Then here 4.861. Then here 4.862. 4.863. 4.864. 4.865. 4.866. 4.867. Okay, 4.868, 4.869 and here 4.870. And our number is, where is our number? 4.862, 4.862 here. Understood? So in this way we have visualized the given decimal number 4.862 on the number line. Let us revise the process again. See, as remember here in this number there are three decimal places. That's why you need to draw three number lines. Okay, you will need to draw three number lines. First number line you have to draw. Before that you have to think that 4.862 comes between these two numbers. That is, it is greater than 4 and less than 5. That's why it comes between 4 and 5. So on the number line, we have located 2 points 4 and 5. Okay, and then the part between 4 and 5, line segment between 4 and 5, we have divided into 10 equal parts and we have given decimal number to each part. Okay, then after that, here we have 4.8 and 4.9. So we know that 4.862 comes between 4.8 and 4.9. That's why this part we have enlarged, we have zoomed. Okay, and here 4.8, 4.9, again same process we have repeated. That is, we have divided this part between 4.8 and 4.9, we have divided into 10 equal parts, and further we have given number to the each point. Okay, and again we come to know that our number 4.862 comes between 4.86 and 4.87. Understood? So that's why this part we have enlarged. Okay, and here between 4.86 and 4.87, here we got our number 4.862. Understood? If there will be two decimal places, you need to draw only two number lines. Okay? So now pause this video, write this example in your notebook. After that, we'll see second one. Then see, our second example is 3.765. 3.765. Okay? What you have to do, think first. Think that 3.765 comes between which two whole numbers? So you know that 3.765 is greater than 3. 3.765 is greater than 3 but less than 4. That means it comes between 3 and 4. So on this number line, we locate point 3 and 4, and the part or line segment between 3 and 4, we will divide into 10 equal parts, and we have divided it already, and let's give the decimal numbers to each part. Here 3 means 3.0 actually, okay, 3.0, 3.0, then here 3.1, 3.2, 3.3, 3.4, 3.5, 3.6, 3.7, 3.8, 3.9 and 3.10 means nothing but 4. Understood? So in this way we have given a number to each point. After that, 3.7, okay, 3.765 means this number we will find on the number line. 3.7, where it is? Here it is, 3.7. And after 7 there is 6.5, means the number is between 3.7 and 3.8. Okay, here between 3.7 and 3.8, here somewhere. That's why we need to enlarge this part. So let us enlarge this part, 3.7 to 3.8. Okay, you can use your scale, ruler. Okay, now say 3.7, 3.8, let us write here 3.7, your 3.8. Okay, now your 3.7 means 3.70. Then we have here 3.71, 3.72, 3.73, 3.74, 3.75, 3.76, 3.77, 3.78 and 3.79. Okay, now again see, here we have now 3.76. Where is 3.76 on the number line here? Here it is, 3.76. So the number is 3.765. That means it will come between 3.76 and between 3.76 and 3.77. Okay, so it will be here somewhere. That's why we need to enlarge this line segment, the line segment between 3.76 and 3.77. So let us do that. Here it is. Okay, 3.76 and 3.77. See, here 3, then 3.7 here, and here 3.76. Okay. Now after 3.76, which number you will get? 3.761. 3.76 2. 3.76 3. 3.76 4. 3.76 5. 3.76 6. 3.76 7. 3.76 8. Sorry. 3.76 9. See now, where is our number? 3.765. Where it is? 3.765. Here it is. Make box to it. Okay. So this is our given number. We have visualized on the number line. Understood? And it is very small number. That's why we need to take a magnet. We need to magnify this. Okay. We need to take lens and we need to magnify this. That's why this process is also called successive magnification. This process is also called successive magnification. Okay, so sometime while asking questions, they will ask the question in this way. Visualize the given decimal number on the number line using successive magnification or process of successive magnification. Okay, so this process means nothing but this. Understood? Again, pause this video and write this example in your notebook. Then let us see the example number 3, 4.27 bar up to 4 decimal places. The question is represent or visualize the 4.27 bar up to 4 places, up to 4 decimal places on the number line. Okay. So the example is 4.27 bar. Okay, and as this is non-terminating recurring decimal, that's why they have given here up to 4 decimal places, because these here decimal places are non-terminating, means never ending. 27, 27, 27, it will be continuous, forever. Okay, that's why they have clearly mentioned that represent 4.27 bar up to 4 decimal places. Okay, so here bar is over block of 27. So 27, 27, like this there will be repetition of the digits. So up to 4 places, that's why our number will be 4.2727 up to this 4 places. Okay, if they will be asked up to 3 places, then 272. For 6 places, 272727. Understood what your places they will ask. Okay. Now see, 4.2727. This number comes between these two numbers. Here, 4 point means whole number is 4. And after 4, there are some points. Means the number comes between 4.2727 is less greater than 4. But less than 5, correct? That means it comes between 4 and 5. So, here write 4 and here write 5. So, see, write here 4 and here 5, and the line segment between 4 and 5, let us divide into 10 equal parts. So, here 4, then here 4.1, 4.2, 4.3, 4.4, 4.5. 4.6, 4.7, 4.8, 4.9 and 5. 4.10 means 5. Okay. So first state we have completed. Now see, 4.2727. So see this number 4.2. Where it is 4.2? Here. Okay, 4.2. And this 4.2727 will be obviously between 4.2 and 4.3. So that's why we need to enlarge this part between 4.2 and 4.3. Okay? So do that.
and 4.3. Okay. So you need to write here 4.2 and here 4.3. So after 4.2, 4.21. What we have done? The line segment between 4.2 and 4.3, it is divided into 10 equal parts. Divide that part into 10 equal parts, then 4.21, 4.22, 4.23, 4.24, 4.25, 4.26, 4.27, 4.28, 4.29 and 4.30. Understood? Now, see here 4.2 over, then you 4.27. Where it is 4.27 on this number line? Here it is, 4.27. Okay, so 4.2727 comes between 4.27 and 4.28 here, between these two. Okay, so this part we need to enlarge. Let us do that. Okay, here 4.27 and here 4.28. Again, the part between 4.27 and 4.28 divided into 10 equal parts. I have already divided, you have to make it new and you have to divide. Okay, then 4.27, after that 4.271. Here 4.27 is 4.270. Then 4.271, 4.272, 4.273, 4.274, 4.275, 4.276, 4.277, 4.278, 4.279. And 4.279 is 79 and then 80, that's why 80. Okay. Now 4.272. Where it is 4.272? Here. 4.272 7 is this number. 4.2727. It will come between 4.272 and 4.273. That's why we need to enlarge this part. Means the portion or line segment between 4.272 and 4.273. Okay, so again we need to draw one number line where we have to enlarge this portion 4.272 and 4.273. Okay, here we will get 4.272 and here 4.273. Understood? Now this, the line segment between 4.272 and 4.273, we need to divide into how many equal parts? 10 equal parts, right? So let us divide. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10, and then put the numbers 4.2720, then 4.2721, then 4.2722, 4.2723, 4.2724, 4.2725, 4.2726, 4.2727, 4.2728, 4.2729, and here 4.2730. Okay? So in this way, we have showed this number, where this number 4.2727, where it is on this number line? mark that, find that and mark that. Make a box with 4.2727. Here it is. Is this point. Okay? So the number, the decimal number, it may be of 2 digit or 3 digit or 4 digit, whichever we can represent that on the number line. Now see here, there are 4 decimal places. That's why we need to draw 4 number lines. Okay, we have required 4 number lines to draw. If there would be 3 decimal places, how many number lines? We require 3 number lines. Okay. So I hope you have understood this representation of decimal numbers. The decimals with the terminating decimal places and non-terminating recurring. Okay. So this is the method. Few examples I'll give you to solve. So you have to solve that, and its answer key I will provide during the doubt session. Okay. So thank you for today and have a nice day.